Yes.
Okay, I'm Mr. Kaucher from StopTTIP. And so the point I want to bring to you, we obviously need more people concerned about climate change, and we need higher concern about climate change. But we also more generally need to be informed about what we're up against as well. And the biggest enemy to progressive change and including in climate change action is the systematic power of transnational corporations, and especially and including financial services, which are called banks for short. It's a huge power that translates into political power and into policy making. So for instance, here in the UK, all three major political parties do the bidding of transnational corporations, and particularly here, financial service corporations, banks. That corporate power is fixed, becomes permanently fixed in law via international trade agreements. And we don't hear very much about the international trade agreements, but that's no accident. They are particularly kept off the screen. Now we're looking at the biggest bilateral trade deal, the US-EU Transatlantic Trade and Investment Partnership, TTIP. The aim for TTIP is to include everything except anything that's particularly exempted, so it's encompassing in that sense, to, along with the so you've got the EU and the US, and in parallel, Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement, taking out most of the world, so the aim is to gradually pull in all the other countries, so comprehensive in that sense as well, and tied into international trade law, which regulates and includes future governments as well, so permanently and forever, so universal in that sense as well. So it's that big. So a main part of this particular deal, the TTIP, is, and also the Trans-Pacific one, is the harmonising of regulation. So the US and EU regulations, these are the regulations that protect us from corporations generally, harmonising them so that they match up, they come together, but in such a way as to suit corporations. So what we're looking at is downgrading of regulation to suit corporations. And in this way, it's corporations achieving policy control. And this deal will also allow corporations to sue governments for regulations that they don't like that affect their future profits. So that's a really big power over governments again. And that is becoming the norm. That investor state dispute settlement allows that. It's becoming the norm. So it's necessary to know and understand what we're up against in order to fight it. Make sure you've got this leaflet, which gives you quite a lot of information about TTIP. So I'm doing a workshop this afternoon about TTIP, and this one too is for a future meeting in a week or so's time, particularly about environment and TTIP. TTIP will affect very broadly our lives, and this meeting here next week will be particularly about the environment and TTIP side of things. I just want to come off track and talk more positively for a minute. There's a figure going around that 67% of people are disengaged on climate change, and I suggest that there's a very strong element there of disempowerment and inevitability. So I'd like to mention something I was lucky enough to come across recently, which was the Centre for Alternative Technology, the organisation in Wales, their Zero Carbon Britain Task Plan, because it's a visionary thing. So it's about how to have a zero carbon Britain without great hardship. And to have the UK, which was a fundamental cause of so much industrial damage, as a model for a zero carbon reality. So when I heard about that, I found it really exciting, and it really stimulated my re-engagement with climate change issues. I guess that's because I'm a grandmother, this is the sort of long-term stuff that that the echo did me. So I would recommend that you seek out that Zero Carbon Britain report from CAT and plug it. And because it is plug it as a positive vision and as a way to engage people and urgently too.